Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidil Anbiya'i wal Mursaleen. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وَمَنْ تَطَوَّعَ خَيْرًا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَاكِرٌ عَلِيمٌ وقال تبارك وتعالى إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ وقال تبارك وتعالى إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ حَنِيفًا وَلَمْ يَكُ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ اجْتَبَاهُ وَهَدَاهُ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ وعن المغيرة بن شعبة رضي الله عنه قال أن كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ليقوم ليصلي حتى ترم قداه أو ساقاه فيقال له فيقول أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Dear brothers and sisters, you know that people are celebrating Thanksgiving Day, which was yesterday, the fourth Thursday of November, which is celebrated as a holy day in the United States. This is an annual holiday which is celebrated due to the blessings of the past year, that the people have been blessed with many blessings in the past year. So literally or traditionally, they try to direct their thanks to God. And these thanks are accompanied with feast and prayers. My brothers and sisters, thanking somebody or thanks or to thank, there's a word which is used in Arabic, ash-shukr. When you thank someone, you say thank you. Sometimes you use the word shukr, which is the Arabic word, and which is from shakara yashkuru shukran, to thank. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned this word at various places, in many places in the glorious Quran. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, says la'allakum tashkurun. Sometimes he says وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Sometimes he is شَاكِرٌ عَلِيمٌ. Sometimes إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Various forms of the word shukr, and this is thanking somebody. When we look upon the meaning of the word thank, and which is shukr in Arabic, ulama have mentioned that shukr or thanking is irfanul ihsan. That somebody has done something good to you, he has given something as a gift to you, he has presented something to you, or he has done a favor to you. So as a thank, you recognize that favor which was done to you through various ways. Sometimes you say thank you and you use your tongue. You say Jazakallah, Shukran, thank you, Shukriya, whatever. And also sometimes it is recognized with the heart, that you feel that somebody has honored you with a present and he has given you a gift and he has a respect towards you. So you recognize that respect and you also do the same thing to him. And sometimes you thank somebody through your actions. Through your actions, for example, somebody has done a favor to you and you thank the person in action. Let's say you do some favor to him by giving him some gift, or sometimes inviting him with you towards to your house or whatever. So these are things how the thanking or shukr is expressed by human beings. And that is what That is what ulama have mentioned, that ash-shukru zuhuru athari ni'matillahi ala lisani 'abdi. If a person has favored you something, it is a ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in his heart, and then he is doing this favor to you. So shukru atharu zuhuru athari ni'matillahi ala lisani 'abdi thana'an wa i'tirafan. That he praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that and he recognizes it. وَعَلَىٰ قَلْبِهِ شُهُودًا وَمَحَبَّةً. Also he testifies that, he believes with his heart that this is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is recognizing it. He is testifying it and he loves it, that it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَلَىٰ جَوَارِحِهِ إِنْقِيَادًا وَطَاعَةً. And also on his faculties, by inclination, that you feel humble in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are obedient towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the favor that you received. This is the meaning of shukr. And that indicates, my brothers and sisters, that there are three parts of shukr: your tongue, your heart, and your actions. If the shukr is out of these three things, that cannot be shukr in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, you are giving somebody something as a gift. So this is a blessing that Allah has given you, and you are sharing this blessing with somebody else. But you are doing it just to show off. You don't believe in that with your heart, or you are not doing it with your heart. So that shukr or that thanking might be out of blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might have heard the hadith which is reported by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. He said, مُطِيرَ النَّاسُ عَلَىٰ عَهْدِ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم فَقَالَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم أَصْبَحَ مِنَ النَّاسِ الشَّاكِرُ وَمِنْهُمْ كَافِرٌ قَالُوا هَذِهِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى وَقَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ لَقَدْ صَدَقَ نَوْءُ كَذَا وَكَذَا قَالَ فَنَزَلَتْ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ حَتَّى بَلَغَ وَتَجْعَلُونَ رِزْقَكُمْ أَنَّكُمْ تُكَذِّبُونَ. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that people had rain at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that some people became shakir. They thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of this blessing. But some of them became kafir. They said that the rain was due to the blessings and the mercy, or because of some particular stars. So the people who said hadihi rahmatullah, they recognized the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with their tongue and with their heart. And as a shukr, maybe you see sometimes that people go and they perform salat al-shukr, or they do whatever they can do, whatever they are capable to do as shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the people who saw the rain, they say that this is due to some stars, this and that. They became kafir, that they did not recognize the mercy, the blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, this is recognizing the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the heart and with your tongue. Also, you might have read the verses in the glorious Quran in Surah Saba, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about Dawood alayhi salatu wa salam. We know that Dawood alayhi salatu wa salam was given a lot of blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam, you might have read the whole story in Surah An-Naml about Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Saba mentions, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا يَا جِبَالُ أَوْبِبِي مَعَهُ الطَّيْرُ وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدُ أَنْ يَعْمَلْ سَابِغَاتٍ وَقَدِّرْ فِي السَّرْدِ وَأَعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ وَلِسُلَيْمَانَ الرِّيحَ غُدُوُّهَا شَهْرٌ وَرَوَاحُهَا شَهْرٌ وَأَسَلْنَا لَهُ عَيْنَ الْقِطْرِ وَمِنَ الْجِنِّ مَنْ يَعْمَلُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِ وَمَنْ يَزِغْ مِنْهُمْ عَنْ أَمْرِنَا نُذِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ يَعْمَلُونَ لَهُ مَا يَشَاءُ مِنْ مَحَارِيبَ وَتَمَاثِيلَ وَجِفَانٍ كَالْجَوَابِ وَقُدُورِ الرَّاسِيَاتِ اعْمَلُوا آلَ دَاوُودَ شُكْرًا وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ. In these ayahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that indeed we bestowed grace on Dawood alayhi salatu wa salam from us. And we said, O you mountains, glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with him. And you birds, you also glorify with him. And we made the iron soft for him, saying, make you perfect coats of mail, and balance well the rings of chain armor, and work you men righteousness. Truly, I am all seer of you, of what you do. And to Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that we subjected the wind. Its morning was a month's journey, and its afternoon was a month's journey. That is, in one day he could travel 2 months' journey. And we caused a fount of molten brass to flow for him. And there were jinns that work in front of him by the leave of his Lord, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whosoever turned of them turned aside from our command, we shall cause him to taste of the torment of the blazing fire. They work for him as he desired. They used to make for him high rooms, min maharib wa tamathil, and also big images, and wajifarin, and basins as large as reservoirs, and cooking cauldrons fixed in their places. My brothers and sisters, and at the end of the verse, Allah says, work you, O family of Dawood, with thanks, but few of my slaves are grateful. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining about his favors that he has given to Dawood alayhi salatu wa salam and Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam, and how many people, or some of them, were grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but most of them were ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, if you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah at the end of my talk I will mention the benefits of the shukr, that what benefit you get if you are thankful towards your brother, towards your friend, or towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might have studied Suratul Kahf, and in Suratul Kahf there are many ayahs in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a parable, an example of two men. One of them was ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the other one was grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dealt the person who was ungrateful to him. You might have read, وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلَ الرَّجُلَيْنِ جَعَلْنَا لِأَحَدِهِمَا جَنَّتَيْنِ مِنْ أَعْنَابٍ وَحَفَفْنَاهُمَا بِنَخْلٍ وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمَا زَرْعًا. And I don't want to say anything. Just you go through reading of these verses, and inshallah you will understand that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dealt with those two people. One was grateful and one was ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, and put forward to them the example of two men, and to one of them we had given two gardens of grapes, and had surrounded both the gardens with date palms, and had put between them green crops, cultivated fields. كلتا الجنتين آتت أكل لها ولم تظلم منه شيئا وفجرنا خلالهما نهرا. This is how Allah is explaining about the gardens, the two gardens which were given to that person. Each of these two gardens brought forth its produce and failed not in the least therein. And we caused a river to gush forth in the midst of the two gardens. وكان له ثمر. And he had the property of the fruit that he was blessed, he was bestowed upon by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقَالَ لِصَاحِبِهِ وَهُوَ يُحَاوِرُهُ أَنَا أَكْثَرُ مِنْكَ مَالًا وَأَعَزُّ نَفَرًا. He was looking at his gardens and he was feeling proud. And while talking to his friend, he said, فَقَالَ لِصَاحِبِهِ وَهُوَ يُحَاوِرُهُ. He said to his friend when he was discussing with him or in a mutual talk, أَنَا أَكْثَرُ مِنْكَ مَالًا وَأَعَزُّ نَفَرًا. That I have more mal than you have, and I receive more respect than you because of these two gardens or because of the property I have. وَدَخَلَ جَنَّتَهُ وَهُوَ ظَالِمُ. He took his friend to his garden, and وَهُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِي, and he was unjust to himself. قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ أَن تَبِيدَ هَذِهِ أَبَدًا. He said that I think these gardens will be forever for me, and I don't think that they will ever perish. And وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمَةً. And I don't believe in the day of judgment, that will never come. He said in his through his actions and through his tongue, وَمَا أَظُنُّ السَّاعَةَ قَائِمَةً وَلَئِن رُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِنْهَا مُنْقَلَبًا. And if I'm returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then I will find better than these two gardens. قَالَ لَهُ صَاحِبُهُ وَهُوَ يُحَاذِرُ أَكَفَرْتَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَكَ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ ثُمَّ سَوَّاكَ رَجُلًا. The other friend, who was a believer, He said to his friend who was a disbeliever, he said, قَالَ لَهُ صَاحِبُ وَهُوَ يُحَاذِرُ. In that talk, أَكَفَرْتَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَكَ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. Do you disbelieve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are you ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has created you from a dust? Are you ungrateful towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has created you from the nutfa? مِنْ نُطْفَ ثُمَّ سَوَّاكَ رَجُلًا. And then he formed you, he fashioned you into a big man. Are you ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? لَكِنَّهُ اللَّهُ رَبِّي وَلَا أُشْرِكُ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. He said, the believer man said that, but I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is my Lord, and whatever I have, I am thankful towards him. And I do not associate anything with him. My Lord is alone, and he is my creator, he is my sustainer, and he is my provider. وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قُلْتَ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ إِنْ تَرَانِي أَنَا أَقَلَّ مِنْكَ مَالًا وَوَلَدًا. The believer friend is saying that when you entered your garden and you showed it to me, you must have said, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. That this is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one has power except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, فَعَسَى رَبِّي أَنْ يُؤْتِيَنِ خَيْرًا مِّنْ جَنَّتِكَ وَيُرْسِلَ عَلَيْهَا حُسْبَانًا مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتُصْبِحَ صَعِيدًا زَلَقًا. The believer friend is saying that you are thinking, I don't have any property, and I don't have maal, I don't have baneen, and sons and daughters, children. He says, وَلَوْلَا فَعَسَى رَبِّي أَنْ يُؤْتِيَنِ خَيْرًا مِّنْ جَنَّتِكَ. I believe in Allah. So due to that belief, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to bless me, and he will give me more than you have. And might be that a calamity comes to your property, and because of that ungratefulness, that will be destroyed by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيُرْسِلَ عَلَيَّ حُسْبَانًا مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتُصْبِحَ صَعِيدًا زَلَقًا. It may be that my Lord will give me something better than your garden, and will send on it husbana, torment, or a bird from the sky, then it will be a slippery earth. أَوْ يُصْبِحَ مَاؤُهَا غَوْرًا فَلَنْ تَسْتَطِيعَ لَهُ طَلَبًا. If you keep on being ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the calamity will come. And also the water thereof, the gardens become deep, sunken underground, so that you will never be able to seek it, to seek this blessing which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. وَأُحِيطَ بِثَمَرِ فَأَصْبَحَ يُقَلِّبُ كَفَّيْهِ عَلَى مَا أَنْفَقَ فِيهَا وَهِيَ خَاوِيَةٌ عَلَى عُرُوشِهَا وَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمُشْرِكْ بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. He said, so his fruits were encircled with ruin, and he remained clapping his hands with sorrow over what he had spent upon it. While it was all destroyed on its trellises, he could only say, would that I would have ascribed no partners to my Lord. Now he is feeling sorrow to himself. He is feeling sad that he would have not associated any partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my brothers and sisters, when any afa, any calamity, or anything related to adab comes to human beings, وَلَمْ تَكُلْ لَهُ فِئَةٌ يَنْصُرُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مُنْتَصِرًا. Then he had no group of men to help him against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nor could he defend or save himself from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says at the end of these ayah, هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ لِلَّهِ الْحَقِّ وَخَيْرٌ ثَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ عُقْبًا. He believed only in this worldly life, and he did not believe in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the wilaya, the dominion, is of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here as well as in the hereafter. And that will be the best abode for those who believe. Then on the day of resurrection, al-wilaya, protection, power, and authority, and kingdom, that all will be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, the true God. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the best for reward and the best for the final end. My brothers and sisters, if you continue reading this surah and the ayahs after this, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about this worldly life and how it is in front of you. We might give a lot of emphasis on our worldly things. We might forget to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings he has given us. Our property, our cars, our these aeroplanes and these trains and these cars and big houses and these mansions and everything. My brothers and sisters, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا إِنَ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فاختلط به نبات الأرض فأصبح هشيما تدروه الرياح وكان الله على كل شيء مقتدرا. And put forward to them the example of the life of this world. It is like the water, like the rain, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down from the sky. And the vegetation of the earth mingles with it and becomes fresh and green, but later it becomes dry and broken pieces, which the winds scatter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do everything, whatever He can do. My brothers and sisters, through the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, we are reminded that they are not our property. They are the property of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us these things, and He will watch us. He is watching us, how we are using it and how thankful to we are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, we should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through prayers, through fasting, through any good deed which you perform for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why ulama have mentioned that a shukr or thanking is a salat. A salat shukr, wa siyam shukr, wa kullu khayrin lillahi shukr, wa afdal shukr alhamdulillah. My brothers and sisters, thanking someone is a sifa, which is a sifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Allah mentioned in the Quran, وَمَن تَطَوَّعَ خَيْرًا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَاكِرٌ عَلِيمٌ. And also, إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ وَاللَّهُ شَكُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. Shukr, thanking somebody, is a sifa of the Anbiya alayhim salatu wa salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, for example, about Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam, ذُرِّيَّةَ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعْنُوحِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِ اجْتَبَاهُ وَهَدَاهُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. That he was grateful, he was thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings he got, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him as a prophet, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. My brothers and sisters, the benefit we get from thanking somebody or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you receive any benefit, any blessing, my brothers and sisters, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through your shukru, through your thanking, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will become happy with you, number one. Number two, you will be protected from the calamities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you if anything comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the form of adab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase the blessings if you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessings you got from Allah. Allah says, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. That if you do shukr, if you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His favors, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase that. And my brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us a big reward in the hereafter, and that is the Jannah. That's why at various places in the Quran, Allah says, وَسَنَجْزِ الشَّاكِرِينَ وَسَيَجْزِ اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to perform this duty, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the shakirin, among the people who thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His favors. Wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We have 5 minutes for sunnah.